What's good, YouTube? This is what you are back at y'all again with another art tutorial. Today I will be teaching you guys how to shade and Procreate. If you're new to the channel, go ahead and hit that like button, comment, subscribe. Make sure you hit post notifications so you will be notified every time your boy drops some heat. Today's video, I will be drawing a very successful, talented singer that go by the name of Trey. He's in a group. It's called Trey and Armand. They got some dope tracks. If you want to check them out, you need to go check them out on YouTube. Without further ado, let's jump right into this video. So every time I start, when I'm working inside of Procreate, I go ahead and create me a new layer on top of the picture I'm finna use. But what we're gonna do, we're gonna select the picture and we're gonna drop the opacity down. Okay, once you do that, you wanna come back to the layer that's sitting above it. Click your brush, go to inking, and we're gonna click the one right under fine tip, the technical pen brush. You wanna go inside of it, and then you wanna click streamline and bring it all the way up. Now, what this is going to do is going to kind of auto correct your lines when you're drawing. And I like to move it all the way up when I'm doing my line work. So now we're going to zoom in close as we can. And we're going to start working on our line work. To fill in closed areas, what you want to do, you want to grab the paint and you want to drag it and just drop it inside. Drag the paint, drop it inside. I'm gonna bring our brush kind of in the center. We're gonna do the same thing with the eyes. As far as making a closed area, bringing the paint and dropping it inside. You wanna get a dope looking cartoon head, you wanna try to make your lines crisp, clean as possible. Same thing with the other eye, we're just gonna drag and drop, fill in color. Drag and drop. Zoom in a little closer. That's my favorite feature about this program, just being able to drag and drop a color. What we're gonna do, we're gonna make sure we close off our lines. Now what we finna do, go to your touch up brush, then you wanna click short hair, and you don't wanna move your streamline up too much. You can move it to 10.4 so it'll give you more control. And now we finna go to the eyebrows. We're gonna got a nice little look. We're gonna make our brush a little smaller, and we're gonna comb. Same thing for his mustache. We're gonna do too much. We're just gonna do a little bit. What we're gonna do, go back to our brushes. We're gonna finish doing the outline of the ears. We're gonna go to your inking brush, and then you wanna go to technical pen. And while we still got it on the same settings, we're gonna go ahead and finish our line work. I'm gonna show y'all a little trick I like to use, a little technique. You see how all this is black right here, and we wanna get all the little details out the hairs, but we wanna cover as much as ground as we can. So what you wanna do is you wanna bring your line up and bring it as close as you can to the hairs. Just bring it close. Just bring it close as you can, but not too close, because we still want to add the real looking effect. And we're just going to drop paint. Then we're going to do the same thing to his beard. Okay, now that we did that part, what you want to do, you want to come to your brush, and let me find it. Go back to your touch-up brush, and then we're going to do the short hair. I think it's the short hair or the flowing hair. I'm not sure. But let's try the short hair out first. Yes, you want to go to your short hair, and you want to bring your size up over here on it. And now we finna add we're gonna give it a real looking effect. What you wanna do, just wanna keep coming around just like that, just give it texture. And that's why we left room around the edges, so we can come on around and give it that real realistic looking detail. Okay, now that we did that, we're gonna go back to our touch up brushes, and we're gonna try out the flowing hair. Just want to see what that, okay, they give a nice looking effect. So we're gonna go on top of what we just did with the flowing hair. Give it a little more little flavor, you know what I'm saying? Give it a little more texture. Just mix it in. And now we're gonna do the same thing for the beard gang, you feel me? We're gonna do the same thing down here. With these different texture brushes, it kind of buy you so much time. As soon as you get the hang of it, it's just, you can utilize all these different brushes and make a dope cartoon head. Now we're gonna go up, we're gonna click our noise brush and bring it down, and we're gonna come right here, we're gonna make it smaller. We're just gonna fill in, make it a little bigger. Okay, make it a little more bigger, and we just gotta start. I'm gonna teach y'all how to do a little nice little fit. You wanna click this like a little S. You want to click that, and you see where the sideburns at, the edges. We're going to come right here, and we're going to create an imaginary one. Okay, what you want to do, you want to come back and close it off. And now you want to click the brush again. And what it do is, it only lets you draw inside that area you just created. So that's how you can just do the nice little edge if you want to just fade it. I'm going to make the spots go. I'm going to make our noise brush go up a little more so we can give it a realistic looking. Now we can click onto the S again to take it off. And there you have it. Nice little fade. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go back to your short hairbrush. I'm gonna kind of bring it in the center, and we're gonna do just a little. Just to keep it, because you don't want it too perfect. I'm gonna kind of give it a realistic looking touch. Looking good so far. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna click the S right here, then we're gonna make an imaginary around the beard, because I want to add a little specks of hair. I'm gonna click your brush after you made your selection, and we're gonna go to our noise brush. Now we're gonna go to the brush above the noise brush. Now we're doing the specks of hair. See? And we ain't gonna do too much. Give it a nice little effect. We're gonna go back to your inking brush. Make sure we close this off. Line work came out pretty good. See what I'm saying? Everything came out real good. Now that we got some good line work going, what you want to do, click back onto your original photo, and you want to click this little arrow right here. You want to bring it down and stick it in the corner and bring the opacity back up. Now it's time to do the shading. So what I like to do is, I like to go to my layer of my line work, and I like to duplicate it like 5 times, and you'll see why I duplicate it so much. It's just it's a habit for me right now. So after I duplicate it, I go straight to the bottom layer of my line work and find a nice little skin tone that we're gonna start with. And I like to go from light to dark. So, see. Let's go ahead and fill in the lights. We got all our basic colors. We got all our basic colors laid out. So now what we finna do, we're gonna click onto it, and you're gonna click select. Now what that's gonna do is, it's gonna let you only color inside the lines of the whole head. So now that we do that, we want to click this layer right above it, and now we're going to find a little darker skin tone. So what you want to do is, to find a skin tone, you want to hold on to it. Dang, my touchpad ain't tripping. Want to hold on to it, and then it'll let you find the color. And then when you let it go, the color will move up here. So now what I like to do is, when I'm doing shading on the skin, I like to go to my noise brush. And you find that in your touch-ups. But once I go to my noise brush, I just start the basic shades. And when you start with the noise brush, it's like a good blend, because I start with the noise brush and then I go to like my airbrush. So. Just gonna start out with some light shading and bring it down some. And it's very precious, and it's like the pressure you use. I'm going light, I'm not going too hard. In a circular motion, kind of light. So make sure you're not pressing too hard. The harder you press, the darker you get. Now close to this one side of the face, I notice I'm gonna go a little darker. And under the nose has a lot of shading. So go ahead and do that. I noticed the shadows is hitting harder on this side of his face. So make our brush a little bigger. Go a little darker, so I'm pressing harder right here. And it don't matter if we color on the eyes, because we're gonna make another layer for the eyes, and we're gonna put it above all the colors. So no matter what I do, it'll stick out on top. Brush a little bigger, and we're gonna get under the neck. It's dark on this side, so we can be kind of hard, and then we want to kind of ease off of it the more we go to this right side here. Okay, and now that we got that, we want to click right here closer under this eye, just for that darker shade. We're gonna go right here, right in that pocket. And I'm gonna shade right here. As you can see, I'm kind of using the original picture for a good reference for where I should put my shades and my shadows. Okay. Notice the shadow is more on this left side, so that's why we're making it more darker to the left, but the closer it's going to the right, it's gonna lighten up. Yeah. Now we're gonna move out one of our layers under that shade, under that shading layer. We're gonna move one layer under that. While we still got it selected, as you can see, you can't really see it on here, but I got just this area selected, so it won't let me color outside of it. And that is a big help. So So what we're gonna do is we're gonna find a layer that's not too dark but not too light, and you just want to keep using the different skin tones that's on the original picture. And you want to try to use it in the same areas it's used on the original picture. What I like to do after I get the shades right, I like to combine my shadings by sliding them together, and I like adding a new line work layer. Cause I always do that method of combining shades, adding new line work layers. And what we can do, we can go after we combine the shadings, we can go to the shadings layer. And now we can come back with our eraser tool. Let's see what size. I want to make it small so I don't go outside the lines. And we can bring that eye back. I need to make it a little smaller because I see him going outside the lines. We can bring that eye back. And really, we can do this at the very end. I just wanted to show you guys. Let's go to the layer, the second layer of our line work. And we're going to click the color white. And we're going to go back to our noise brush. And we're going to kind of bring it down. And what we're going to do is we're going to add them little highlights. And that's what's going to give it more dimension. It's going to give it a more, it's going to help everything stick out. Did that. Go to your layers. You want to go to the shading layers. And now we finna pull out the airbrush. What you can do, you can click the first one and you can make this brush bigger. We're gonna select this color and we're gonna kind of blend it. We're gonna go light though, so now it'll give it a smooth effect. We're gonna click all our shadows and we wanna kind of add a small little blend, but not too much, just to give it a more smoother feel. Okay. See, I want to add more shadow right here. Now we finna click the darkest brown we can find. Make our airbrush smaller. We're gonna come right in this nose right here. It's a pretty good process to when you shade and skin, but once you figure out a nice little method, you get you a nice routine, you'll get you a nice, get you some nice results at the end. Duplicate. Okay, we go. I'm gonna show you why I'm making these eyes red on a new layer. So now, what we just made the eyes red, you wanna select it, and you wanna go to select, and we're gonna erase it. And it's the same method we did that, so we can only, when we color, it'll only color inside the eyes. Now we can click off of it. We're gonna do the same thing for his teeth. Now we finished our shading on our cartoon head. Finish everything. Everything looking nice. Now what we finna do, we're gonna add the glares in the eyes. What you wanna do, you wanna select the color white. Go to your soft brush inside your airbrush. Create a new layer that's on top of everything. And now we're gonna zoom into the eyes. Oh. Gotta make this brush super small. Do this. Okay, we did that. Now we just did the nice little fake inside the eyes. We still got it selected. We're gonna go to like a yellowish white. And you wanna go to your hairbrush inside your touch-ups. And we're gonna go to short hair. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna add this little effect. We'll make our brush kinda in the center. We're gonna add this little hair effect. Just to give it some sauce, you feel me? And then we're gonna come to the top, do the same thing. There you have it, man. How to make a dope cartoon head using Procreate on your iPad. If you're new to the channel, go ahead and smash that like button. More heat coming soon. Thank you guys for tuning in. Thank you for your love and support. You know what I'm saying? And I'm out this thing.